With this tutorial video, we want to go over how to get the student data files for you to be successful in the CIS 118 class. Now, before we actually download those data files, we need to make sure that our flash drive is actually ready and organized as much as possible to make it easier throughout the semester. So go ahead and plug in your flash drive to your computer, and it should automatically recognize that flash drive, and my computer will automatically bring it up for me. If yours doesn't bring it up for you, you can go to File Explorer and click on Computer because it's actually plugged into the computer, so that's our first clue as to how to get to it. And then here's my flash drive, and sometimes it has a generic name such as removable drive. This has a brand name. I have a Kingston flash drive. You might have Lexar or a different kind of media. This doesn't really give me an idea of the difference between this flash drive and maybe my personal flash drive that has family photos and family documents on it. So if you ever want to, you can always rename this flash drive. Now, fair warning, when you rename it, you actually have to erase all flash drive. So before you do this, go into your flash drive, and if you have anything in here, move it to your desktop and then erase it, and then later on you can put it back onto your flash drive. So let's go ahead and go back, and I can go to Manage and choose Format. Now, if you're on a Windows 7 system, you can right click and choose Format from that option. So from here, we're gonna go ahead and just do a quick format. That's just gonna erase it and give it a new name. If this flash drive is an old flash drive and you used it a lot, then you might wanna uncheck quick format so that you get a cleaner, more organized flash drive in the end. So for right now, there's nothing on there, so we're just gonna leave this Kingston, and I'm gonna put college work. And it's not letting me type the last letter because there's a limit to how long the name can be. So I'll go ahead and eliminate that space, and that should work out for me. So I'll click start, and it's gonna tell you it's gonna erase everything on it. So make sure to hit cancel and move the stuff that you don't wanna erase off to another place before you do this, and then you can move it back on there. So I'll go ahead and hit okay, and it might go fast, but if it goes slow, it could be because the flash drive is really big or your computer's really slow. So I'll click okay and close, and now my flash drive has a name that is easy to recognize for me. So let's go ahead and get organized for this class. I'll go inside of the flash drive, and I want to create a new folder. So I can create it by just clicking New Folder if I'm on a Windows 8 system. And I'll type the name of the class, CIS 118 Intro to PC Applications. Now, within that folder, we want to create four more folders for the four units that you're going to have assignments for. Now, I can keep going to New Folder, or I can do right-click, New, and Folder. And this method, the right-click method, will also work on a Windows 7 machine. So I'll go ahead and type Word Unit, and right-click, and do PowerPoint Unit. And we'll do two more, Excel Unit, and last but not least, Access. Alright, so now I'm ready to download my data files, and I want to keep them separate based on the software that they relate to. So I'll go ahead and minimize this and go back to the website, and there are written instructions that go over everything we talk about in this video. So if you think you need to, or you prefer written instructions, then that's available for you with some screenshots as well. So for right now, we want to first make sure you're using Mozilla Firefox, so go ahead and click that link. And if you need the newest version or you don't have it at all, it's free and it's one of the best browsers out there and it's very secure. So go ahead and download it here. And that's the browser that D2L was built with, so you should be using Firefox anytime you come into this class. Once you've made sure that you're using the correct browser, you can click on this Book Companion website. And from here, there are a lot of different things you can do for this book that you can maybe practice your quizzes, whatnot, but we're most concerned with data files. So we'll click on that, and you can see that there are links. These are the actual files that you're going to download, and they relate to different software. So this is for the Office in Windows 8. This one's for PowerPoint Chapter 3, Part 2. So sometimes it can get a little bit confusing because Word only has one file. Access only has one file, but PowerPoint Chapters 1 and 2, it has one file, but Chapter 3 has Part 1 and Part 2. And that's because there are big videos in those, so it takes a while to download and they had to break it up. So make sure you ask your instructor which ones you're going to need. You're probably guaranteed to need the Word, Access, and all the different PowerPoint files and Excel. You should be okay to skip the Office in Windows 8 and the Outlook chapters. So let's go ahead and do Word because that's the first one you're going to do. Now, it doesn't give you an easy name like Word data files, it gives you this crazy number. So just remember the last three numbers so you can easily identify this file later. So I'll click on it and it's going to ask me, what do you want to do with this file? So I could open it with Windows Explorer, but then I have a hard time sometimes finding where I'd actually put it. So I'll click Save File and click OK. Now, if you're using Firefox, it's automatically going to download it to our Downloads folder. Makes sense. If you're in a different browser, it could put it in the Downloads folder, it might put it on the desktop, and sometimes it puts it in a place that you never find ever again. So just use my Mozilla Firefox if you can. When the file's ready and it's downloaded, click on this download icon and it'll display that file. And if this was still downloading, we'd see a progress bar. And you can see this tiny little icon that when you hover over it says it'll open the containing folder. Because sometimes when you download stuff, you don't know where it actually went or you don't know how to find where it went. And just so you know, in Firefox, it's always going to go to the downloads folder. So you can click on File Explorer and choose downloads and you should see it. Now, I like to see big icons and I just did that by going to View and changing how I see things. And you can see this is a zip file. It looks like a closed zipper. This allows us to have one file folder that might have multiple files inside of it, but it allows us to just send or download one file to get all of those other files inside of it. The problem is we need to unzip this, or what we call extract. So in order to extract these files, we'll right click on it and choose Extract All. And it's asking us where we want to extract all those files to. And I want to put it on my flash drive so that I can take it home and work on my assignments there, and so I can bring it to the college and work on my assignments in class. So I'll click Browse, and I need to find my flash drive, which is plugged into the computer. There's my flash drive, and it has a good name, easy for me to see, CIS 118 class. And these are the Word files, so I'll choose my Word unit folder. I'll click OK. And I can check or uncheck to show the extracted files when complete. I don't like to show it because I don't like when there's a ton of windows. So I'll just click Extract, and it'll show a progress bar. And it should work. So let's go ahead and close this and minimize this and see if it actually did work. So we'll go to our flash drive on the computer into our CIS 118 folder, Word, and now all of a sudden we have a new folder that we didn't create, but the extraction actually created, and these are the data files for Word chapter 1 through 3. So now I can go in chapter 1, there are all my files, back up a little bit, chapter 2, there are all my files, and again, I like to look at large icons. So that tells me that they're in there. Let's go ahead and try that one more time just to make sure you've got it. Let's do Excel because that should download pretty fast. So this is 509, and it's important to remember that. Again, save file and go to the download and open containing folder. And it's important to remember 509 because this doesn't say Word, this doesn't say Excel, so we know 509 is Excel. So right click, extract all, and we're going to choose our flash drive and choose the Excel unit folder and click extract. And then again, I like to close all the windows, and let's go ahead and click on our flash drive, Excel, and now we have all the data files for that project. So make sure you do that for Word, Excel, Access, and PowerPoint, and then ask your instructor if you need the other files for any reason.